Welcome to the Blazor DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component in a Blazor web app using Visual Studio Code. I will also show you how to populate and customize tabular data in a grid and enable a few important features like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. Visual Studio Code supports the .NET command line interface and the C# dev kit for building Blazor web app. In this tutorial, I will use the C# dev kit for creating the project. Before starting, make sure you have Visual Studio Code with the latest version of the .NET SDK and the C# dev kit. Let's get started. With Visual Studio Code already launched, I open the command palette by pressing Ctrl+Shift+P. Then, I select .NET New Project to set up a new project. Next, I search for and select the Blazor web app template. Then, I change the project name to Blazor app. Next, I select a folder to save the project files and choose a solution format. Then, I continue with the server interactive mode, where components communicate using SignalR to handle real-time updates between client and server. After that, I choose the global interactivity location to make all pages interactive by default. When I click Create Project, the application will be created. I open the Solution Explorer and navigate to the program's CS file. Here, you will notice two methods, Add Interactive Server Components, which enables interactive rendering, and Add Interactive Server Render Mode, which configures the server's rendering mode. Next, I navigate to the AppRaiser component. Here you can see the render mode is set to Interactive Server within the Routes and Head Outlet components. Next, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid component to the app. First, I open the NuGet Package Manager. Next, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Grid and install the latest version. Similarly, I install the latest version of Syncfusion Blazor themes to include the CSS references. Installation is completed. I navigate to the imports Razor file and include the Syncfusion Blazor Grid's namespace, which allows to use the Blazor DataGrid component within the Pages folder. Next, I open the program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service in the Blazor web app. I need to reference the CSS file for the Blazor DataGrid component. So, I navigate to the AppRaiser component and include the CSS reference from the installed package. I have also included the necessary script reference here. Now that everything is configured, I will add the Syncfusion Blazor DataGrid. I open the HomeRaiser component and replace the default code with the DataGrid component. To display the DataGrid, I need to bind a data source to it. So, I create an order model with fields like order ID, customer name, order date, and freight. Then, I define a list of orders based on the order model class. Inside the uninitialized async method, I initialize orders list with sample data containing fields like order ID, customer name, freight, and order date. Finally, I assign the order's data to the grid component's data source property, so the data is displayed when the component loads. To run the application, I select the Run and Debug icon in the activity bar and click on Run and Debug button. Next, I select the C# debugger. Visual Studio Code then opens a menu with different launch configurations, so I just pick the default C# option. After that, the project starts launching. Once launched, the browser will display the data grid with the provided data. To customize and display specific columns in the data grid, I add a grid columns component inside the Syncfusion grid component. Then, inside the grid columns component, I define a grid column component for each specific data field I want to display. Each grid column component represents a separate column and has properties to customize its behavior and appearance. For example, to display the order ID column, I set the field property to order ID. To customize the column header, I set the header text property to order ID. By default, text is left aligned, but I update the text-align property to right. I also specify a fixed width to maintain a consistent layout. I repeat this for the other columns. After saving, I rerun the application. You can see the customized columns. Next, I am going to display a short date format in the order date column. I set the format property to D and specify the column type as date. To show currency values in the freight column, I set the format property to C2. After making these adjustments, you can see the updated column settings in the grid. Now, let's see how to enable some important DataGrid features. I will start with paging. Paging helps manage large data sets by displaying a limited number of records per page. Instead of scrolling through many records, you can break them into smaller, more manageable pages. To enable this feature, I set the allow paging property to true. Next, the grid page settings component can be used to define paging behavior. Here I set the page size to 10 to show only 10 records in a page. I save the changes and run the application. Now the grid organizes data into pages, making navigation easier and improving usability. Next, I will show you how to sort the records in the data grid. To do this, I set the allow sorting property to true. When sorting is enabled, I click a column header like customer name. It instantly sorts the data in ascending order. I click it again, and it switches to descending. It's easy to organize the records. Following this, I will show you how to filter the records based on input criteria. To do this, I set the allow filtering to true. For example, typing a customer name and pressing enter filters the grid to show matching records. Finally, I will enable grouping by setting the allow grouping property to true. Here, I can click and drag the customer name column header and drop it into the group area. The data grid now displays the data grouped under that column, making it easier to analyze related records. Now, let me summarize. I showed you how to add the Blazor DataGrid component to a Blazor web app using Visual Studio Code with C# Dev Kit. Also, I showed how to bind a data source, customize columns, and enable features like paging, sorting, filtering, and grouping. For more information on the DataGrid features, check out the documentation link in the description below. If you would like to explore the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link. I have also provided a link where you can check if you qualify for a free community license to access all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.